In the previous video, we actually got our button to work. We actually got it to display a message on the screen, and we talked about some of the basic functionality that's part of Android. So to finish off this first application, let's extend the functionality. So what we can do is set it up so that every time we click the button, the actual message on the screen, is instead of just showing the same message, will actually show how many times the button's been tapped. So let's get started doing that now. We clear our view a little bit so we can see a little bit better. One of the annoying things about this sometimes is you need to actually specify the command twice before it will actually remove it from the screen. Or in this case, three times. Not too sure why it's doing that. Okay, so what we need now to be able to record how many times something's been clicked, we need a counter. We need some sort of place, a variable, to contain the number of times something's been clicked. So we're going to come up here and we're going to add a variable. And we're going to type in private int. Int means integer, it's short for integer. And we're going to call this one num times clicked. In actual fact, what we'll do is we'll change it. We'll put equals zero. That's a way to initialize it to the value of zero when our program starts. So num times clicked is the name of the variable. Int means it's a data type and it's a whole numbers. And that's going to be perfect for what we actually need. So thinking about it, where would we put this code to increment the counter? Well, the obvious place to put it would be in our onClick listener, where the message came up and said the button got tapped, because we know this code is executed every time the button is tapped. So what we want to do is increment the value of this variable, numTimesClicked, every time this function is called, and remembering that Android tells us when the button is clicked and actually calls this for us and actually starts this code. So to do that, here's one implementation. We can type in num, and notice how it's come up with the variable automatically. So we can type numTimesClicked equals, and type in numTimesClicked again, plus one. What that means is that looking at this side of the statement first, we're saying we want to assign the value of num times clicked, and the value we want to assign is after the equal sign, and it's going to be num times clicked, whatever the value is, and we're going to add one to that. So the first time we run this application, we defined num times clicked to be zero. So looking at this side, zero plus one is one. So for the first time we call this, it's going to have the value of one. Then the next time, num times clicked will be 1, and it's going to be, this will be executed again, it'll be 1 plus 1 is 2, and so on. So it's going to continually add that number. So next we need a way to convert that number, ultimately, so we can put it into our message here. And one way of doing it would be something like this, string. We are introducing a concept of a string, which is yet another variable type, which accepts numbers or letters, alphanumeric characters in other words. We'll call that total equals. We can type something complicated like integer.toString. This is one solution, num times clicked. I'm going to show you this, then I'm going to show you an easy way. And then what we're going to do then is change this message. The button got tapped. What we're going to do is we're going to add to that. We're going to put plus total plus times. So that's one way of doing it. And if we actually run this, we should find that this actually works. So let's go ahead and run that. And tab back over to our emulator. Wait till it updates. So now if I click it, the button got tapped one times. Now notice one times, that's not actually good English. What we should be doing there is if it's been tapped one time, we should actually say one time. But then after that, as we click it two times, three times, four times, it is correct to add the word to add the S to the word times. But anyway, notice how that's updating. It's updating each time we're clicking it, and it quite happily accepts virtually any number that we want to click. So that's good. So let's go back and actually fix that. I'm going to show you how you can actually fix that to make it a lot easier. And I'm going to just clear a bit of space again and see what we're doing. Now I mentioned that this was a bit of a long, convoluted way of doing things. And Android actually makes things a bit easier for us. We can actually do this to actually shortcut that. I can get rid of that line altogether. And I can actually just put num times clicked. And it does the same thing. It starts off with the text and adds the number of times clicked, and then adds the word times after it. But the other thing we need to do now, we need to think, okay, so how can we set this code up so that no matter what, the first time we actually run it, it shows the word time, then the second time it shows the word times when the number is greater than zero. So what we can do is we can actually do something like this. We can come up here and we can put something like if number times clicked is equal to 1, two equal signs means check the value of what numtimes click is. So we're actually saying here, is the value of numtimes clicked 1? If that's the case, we're going to actually add these braces and we're going to put something in there that's like this. I'm just pasting it in there. I'm going to just type the rest of this and then we'll explain. I'll explain what we're doing here. I'm going to paste that code again and put times. But firstly, what I'm going to do is get rid of the S. So what we're doing here, this is the concept of an if test. So we're actually saying, does the number times clicked variable have the value of 1? If it does, we're going to display a message with the word time on the end, which is the correct English. Otherwise, else means otherwise. If the number isn't equal to 1, because 0 would still be valid. If it's been clicked 0 times, we would still say times there. We're actually going to show the word times. So just to check that that works, we're going to run that again, and then I'm going to show you a shortcut to this as well. We'll go back and check our code once it starts. So I'm going to run it, click it the first time. The button got tapped 1 time. That's correct. The button got tapped 2 times, and now it should be doing times each time, so to speak. And you can see that that's working. So that's our little loop there, our little bit of code there that's being executed, testing to see whether the value is 1. If it is, to display the word time, otherwise to display the word times. Now, I'll be talking more about this in detail as we go through the course, but what I've done there isn't good coding. From a programming point of view, it's not good because we've duplicated the code. And what I mean by that is if, for example, we decided we want to change this message and we put the button got clicked, I actually have to type the word clicked in 2 different places. Now, that's not so bad in that example because it's just a simple example, but if I had a lot of code, there would potentially be a lot of extra work to have to update it in multiple places. And of course, the other thing is I could actually make a typo in one of them. So a better way of doing things in that scenario, where possibly something you should be thinking about, is to remove duplication of code. So to do that, instead of actually displaying the message, we're going to create a variable and we're going to assign it to the right value, and then we're going to print it out. So let's go ahead and do that. So I'm going to put it straight after the numlines, numtimes clicked, and we're going to call it a string. We'll call it result equals. And let's just copy this code. I'm going to copy and paste that code. The button got tapped, plus, clicked, plus, time. Now notice how I'm not putting the word times there, like so. So far, the message is going to be the variable result is going to have that value. But what we're going to do then is put some code after that. And we're going to put if numtimes clicked is not equal to 1. So the exclamation mark and an equal means not equal. So it doesn't have the value, in other words. If that's the case, we're going to put result plus equals s. And then lastly, we can then change our output here. We can remove this redundant code here. We can put our message dot set text to be result. And I can actually get rid of this code here. So what we've done is we've now abbreviated our code and made it far more precise. We've still got the variable numtimes clicked, but we've actually added the text value, the contents that we want displayed on the screen into a variable called result. And that's like a memory location that's going to contain the actual text to display on the screen. And then we're doing a test here to say if the number times clicked variable is not equal to 1, add the word s to the end of it. So what should happen is if the value is 1, it should correctly show the word time on the end. Otherwise, it should show the word times. So let's just try running that. Let's check that that does work. Okay, and we'll go back and check our code. Button got tapped 1 time, 2 times, and so that's obviously working nicely. Okay, we'll just tab over, wait till it starts again. I may possibly have been too slow there. Looks like it's already running. So I click on my button. The button got tapped 1 time, 2 times, 3 times. And just to be sure that it is us working, we'll put a full stop after the S. Let's put 3 full stops, just to an indication that we actually are running the correct version of our application. So it should show the word S, or the letter S, with 3 dots after, if we're running this correctly. We go ahead and check that. We can see it restarting there. Click it for the first time. The button got tapped 1 time. Click it again 2 times, and there's 3 dots. So it's actually working fine. So that's how we go about adding a message, and we're actually obviously performing an action when the actual button is clicked. So to finish off this application, let's make another change. Let's go back to our original toast message, and let's also in there, instead of just printing this message, which you can see when I run or click on the settings option got tapped. Let's actually put a message in there, and let's actually put whatever the current value is from the actual text view, the actual text on the screen. Let's put that in there. So how would we do that? Well, we go back to the code. We go back to the section of code that actually displayed the toast message. That's this part here. So why don't we make this, and we'll put delete that, and we'll put text value is now. Now how do we get, the next question is, how do we actually get the value out of our variable? Because if you remember, we assigned a text view called our message, and that's what we're using here to set the text. So I'll give you a hint that the word set is, the set text is actually a hint as to what to do. So set text sets the value. So how would we get the value? We would use a very similar line, but we would use the word get instead of set. So we'd actually put plus get. But before we do that, we have to put our message dot get text. So what we're doing there is we're saying we're telling the Java code to look at the our message view, which of course is the text view that we created that is showing the messages on the screen, and to get the current value, whatever that is, and to put it in this message. So the message that should show on the screen should be text value is now space and then whatever that value is. So let's run that and see if it works. Okay, we'll tap back over. So firstly, we'll click on my button. The button got tapped one time. That's working. So now if I actually click on that and click on settings, text value is now the button got tapped one time. And so every time we call that, it should still be the same thing, which it is. Click on my button. Let's say we'll go to 11 times, and that should now show 11 times in here. And it's correctly got the dots as well. Okay, the very last thing to do is, how do you think we'd go about clicking on this button here? Let's set it up so that when we click it, it shows what the value is, but then it resets the counter again, sets the counter back to zero. So how would we do that? Well, we go back to our code, and we'd go back to the line where the toast is being displayed, the toast message. And on the line after the show command, where we've showed it, we could assign, we could set the variable number times clicked back to zero. So we could type num times clicked equals zero. And again, a single equal sign means we're setting the value, but using two equal signs together means we're checking the value of it. So now that we've done that, so what should happen now is when we run this, it should actually show the correct message, but then it should set the value to zero. So firstly, let's just try it. So the button got tapped six times. So if we set the message up, text value is now the button got tapped six times. But now if we click on my button again, the button got tapped one time, and that's because the value got reset to zero again, and then we've incremented it by one. So consequently, when we click on settings, the button got tapped one time. So there you go, that's our first application. I hope you got a lot out of that. And remember that a lot of the concepts, if you're struggling with anything and you're thinking, you know, a lot of this stuff still doesn't make sense, hang in there, because we'll be going through in a lot more detail, but we really have to start from somewhere. So we started on the basics, things like variables and so forth, and some of these other things will make a lot more sense as we go through looking at more applications, particularly more applications that have got more detail and are a little bit more complex, so that you can understand how it all works. So I'll see you in that next section for our next application.